The Philippine Congress receives the 6.3 trillion peso proposed national budget of President Marcos for next year. The budget is 10% higher than last year, but a lesser amount of about 10 billion pesos has been allotted for confidential and intelligence funds. The Office of the President and some state agencies including the police, the Coast Guard, and the Defense Department, are set to receive secret funds next year, with the Vice President's office still scrapped off special funds.
Sila lang po yung pwedeng may confidential and intel fund. Kaya din po siya bumaba ng 16%.
The government's anti-communist task force, meanwhile, receives a threefold increase in its budget, while funds for health, social welfare, and agriculture declined. House lawmakers vowing to prioritize the marginalized sector once they begin deliberating on the spending plan.
Para sa amin dito sa House of Representatives, malakas din ang pananawagan na magdagdaga ng pondo para sa 4Ps ng DSWD at iba pang programang laan sa mga nasa laylayan ng lipunan. Dapat bigyan din ang sapat na tulong pinansyal ang mga Pilipinong minimum wage earners sa ilalim ng ACAP program, lalo sa panahon ng krisis na dala ng mga digmaan sa ibang bansa.
The deepening alliance between the Philippines and the U.S. taking center stage once again as top officials from Washington visit Manila. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken and Washington's Defense Chief Lloyd Austin will be in Manila for a dialogue with their Philippine counterparts Enrique Manalo and Gibo Teodoro. They are expected to discuss how the two countries can further enhance their commitment to their alliance in support of rules-based international order. This is the fourth high-level dialogue since the so-called 2+2 format began in 2012. The meeting also comes more than a month after a flare-up between the Philippines and China in Ayungin Shoal. Blinken and Austin will also pay a courtesy call on President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. in Malacañang this morning. Now, Vice President Sara Duterte cries foul over the removal of 75 police officers from her security detail. She's calling the move a political harassment. The Vice President believes this was the result of her resignation as education chief and her remarks calling herself the designated survivor during the President's third State of the Nation address. Duterte called out National Police Chief Romel Marbil for allegedly lying about the reason for the downsizing of her security detail. General Marbil has declined to comment on Duterte's latest allegations, but he earlier justified the downsizing, noting the Vice President is still under the protection of the Presidential Security Command. Former Senator Laila De Lima names former President Rodrigo Duterte as the mastermind behind the drug war killings during his administration. Appearing at a House probe on the drug war, De Lima said Duterte must be prosecuted for launching the bloody campaign. She also urged the House panel on human rights to submit any new information that may surface from the probe to the International Criminal Court.
There is no doubt in my mind that former President Rodrigo Duterte is the mastermind, as he was the instigator and inducer of the drug war killings. For his crimes against humanity, both as Davao City Mayor and Philippine President, Duterte should be prosecuted and convicted by the International Criminal Court and spend the remainder of his life in prison.
Monday's drug war hearing at the lower house was supposed to be the last, but the Makabayan bloc insisted the inquiry should not end without Duterte showing up.
Again and again, we've been requesting for the former president to come here para ipaliwanag po yung mga akusasyon sa kanya. Hanggang ngayon, hindi pa rin yun nangyayari. So Mr. Chair, hindi pwedeng matapos sa ganito.
Over now to the upper chamber, where a Philippine senator threatened to hold a former presidential spokesperson, Harry Roque, in contempt during a tense hearing on his alleged links to illegal pogos. Victoria Tulad reports.
After being arrested and detained in the Senate, accountant Nancy Gamo faced the inquiry on Philippine offshore gaming operators on Monday, saying suspended Bamban Tarlac Mayor Alice Gold lied when she denied knowing her. According to Gamo, she has known Go since 2012 and worked on a per-project basis in registering her companies and even the Bamban Pogos Hongsheng and Zunyu One.
Nagsisinungaling po siya. Siya yung nag-refer sa akin. Ang kausap ko mismo sa Hongsheng, siya rin mismo.
In both instances ng Pogo Hub na Hongsheng, Pogo Hub ng Zunyu One, si Alice ang nag-provide, si Alice ang kumontak muna sa inyo to incorporate.
Yes po.
Go was still a no-show during the hearing. According to the Philippine National Police and National Bureau of Investigation, they are still looking for Go, which prompted Senator Jinggoy Estrada to issue an ultimatum. Senator Sherwin Gatchalian recommended the filing of a case against Go for supposedly disobeying summons, which is covered by the revised penal code. In his first appearance in the Senate hearing, former presidential spokesperson Harry Roque maintained that he has nothing to do with Pogos, even ending up in a heated exchange with Committee Chair Senator Risa Ontiveros.
Let us be fair, because you have been insinuating I am a lawyer for Lucky South. That is why...
Excuse me, the chair has not been insinuating anything. The chair and the members of the committee have been asking questions based on the testimonies, sworn testimonies of PAGCOR Chair Tengco.
I maintain, as an officer of the courts, and under oath before the Senate of the Republic of the Philippines, that I have never acted as legal counsel for Lucky South 99 or for any other Pogo.
Ang malinaw po sa komite ay yung organizational chart na yan na may drawing, may box na legal na nandun yung pangalan nyo was one of the official attachments sa submissions ng Lucky South 99 sa PAGCOR.
Ngayon po, sinabi nyo, you again insinuated that I had anything to do with the document. Ayan nga pong sinasabi ko. As far as I know, attorney,
please stop using that offensive verb, insinuating.
Gatchalian warned Roque of contempt.
Attorney Roque, please be reminded to respect the chairperson.
I'm very respectful, Madam Chair.
Paano respectful yung nagsasalita siya? Sinasabayan mo siya.
I apologize, Senator Gatchalian.
One more, I will cite you in contempt.
Roque, meanwhile, clarified that he does not own the house in Tuba, Benguet, where authorities found a female Chinese and male Cambodian in a recent operation. According to the Bureau of Immigration, the man was arrested for being undocumented, while the woman was arrested for possibly hiding an illegal alien.
Ang bahay po na tinutukoy nyo sa Tuba, Benguet ay rehistrado sa isang korporasyon. Tiniran ko po yan nung ako po ay umalis ng gobyerno, and I do have an interest in the corporation that owns it, no? Pero wala po sa akin ang possession ng bahay na yan.
The Cambodian passport held by the man is fake. He is really Chinese. And as per our Chinese informant, he's a red notice fugitive, very high level, and he has already defrauded 100,000 people.
Meanwhile, the Anti-Money Laundering Council said its investigation will take a few more months, but it has allegedly seen that Go is involved in money laundering.
Is she a recipient of illicit money?
I can say now na she's both a recipient and a beneficiary and a sender po. Na-establish na po namin is based on transactions, yung in and out po niya. So there are years po na nasa hundreds of millions.
In his testimony, Dennis Cunanan, the authorized representative of Pogos in Bamban, Porac Pampanga, and Lawag Ilocos Norte, denied accusations that he ran away with the money of Lucky South 99 in Porac, meant to pay for its taxes. Meanwhile, according to Ontiveros, Catherine Cassandra Ong, the authorized representative of Lucky South 99 who accused Cunanan, is already in Singapore. The Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation, or PAGCOR, on the other hand, told the Senate committee that it will meet with different government agencies starting this week to implement the directive of the President banning all POGOs or internet gaming licensees. PAGCOR will give a monthly report on its progress. Victoria Tulad, ABS-CBN News.
Turning now to the oil spill in Bataan, the removal of industrial fuel from the sunken tanker MT Terra Nova may start today as majority of the ship's leaking valves were already sealed. Only 300,000 of the 1.4 million liters of oil need to be drained for the ship to float. The Coast Guard says the coverage of the oil spill has been reduced from 14 to as much as 6 kilometers, but it is spreading towards nearby provinces, including Bulacan, Pampanga, Cavite, and Batangas, with local fishermen bearing the brunt.
Sana po si may bandang Tibagin at meron na rin nakita doon si may bandang Bulacan-Bulacan Taliptip. Nagawa na po tayo ng memo sa ating mga mangingisda at nagpapalaisdaan na hanguin na yung kanilang mga punla doon, o kayo may mga plaga na lang isda, limang hauin na at anihin na, baka kasi hindi na papakinabangan.
Pagkatas po nung kambogan, yung pag-alon, meron po kaming nabahid, napansin. Pero hindi naman po siya ganong makapal, medyo manipis lang po. Mahina po yung panguhuli pag gagalon, kasi yung mabaho yun eh. Lumalayo po yung mga isda.
The Fisheries Bureau is now considering imposing a fishing ban on other areas affected by the oil slick. But the move is expected to affect 11,000 fisherfolk, incurring a monthly loss of about 80 million pesos. The oil tanker insurer is now working on the compensation for those affected by the oil spill. Let's get an update on the weather now from PAGASA forecaster Benison Estradeja. Hi, Benison.
Good morning, Bettina, and all our viewers. As of 3 in the morning, the low-pressure area was estimated at 480 kilometers north of Intlayat, Batanes, and this low-pressure area may dissipate within the next 12 hours and move outside the Philippine area of responsibility. The said low-pressure area also has no effect over any parts of the country. As of now, we have the weak southwest monsoon or habagat affecting the western section of northern and central zone, so expect some cloudy skies still over Ilocos region and Zambales with some light to moderate with at times heavy rains within the next 24 hours. Whereas for Metro Manila and the rest of the country, expect partly cloudy to cloudy skies and again with some isolated rain showers or thunderstorms mostly in the afternoon or evening. Range of temperature over Metro Manila is from 25 to 33 degrees, whereas for Baguio City, 17 to 23 degrees Celsius. And that's the latest from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. This is Benison Estradeja reporting.
Thank you very much for that update, Benison.